ಅನುದಿನ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಯಸ್ ಸರ್
ಯಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್
ದಸೆಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Hello children, welcome to the English class of 8th standard third language. As usual, I hope you are ready with your belongings, textbook, pen, pencil and notebook. Okay children, shall we have our rhyme? Yes, I know you all are fond of rhyme. Okay. See, this is a rhyme about ducks. I will sing. You repeat after me. Are you ready? Good children. Five little ducks went out to play. Over the hills and far away. Mother duck called them quack, quack, quack. Four little ducks came back, back, back. Four little ducks went out to play. Over the hills and far away. Mother duck called them quack, quack, quack. Three little ducks came back, back, back. Three little ducks went out to play. Over the hills and far away. Mother duck called them quack, quack, quack. Two little ducks came back, back, back. Two little ducks went out to play. Over the hills and far away. Mother duck called them quack, quack, quack. One little duck came back, back, back. One little duck went out to play. Over the hills and far away. Mother duck called them quack, quack, quack. None little ducks came back, back, back. None little ducks came back, back, back. I hope you all enjoyed the rhyme on ducks. Okay, children. In the last class, I have assigned you some work. I hope you are ready with the work what has been assigned you in the last class. Shall we check out the answers? Okay. Okay, this was your assignment. Describe the each noun by choosing the adjective from the box. The adjectives are age, blue, beautiful, clean, tasty, long, cute, green. I hope you are ready with your answers. Okay. Yes, children. Green grass. Long hair. Clean room. tasty noodles, beautiful flower, blue sky, cute baby, 8 planets, nice children, very nice. Most of you have done the homework right. And few have you done little mistakes, you can correct it down. Green grass, long hair, clean room, tasty noodles, beautiful flower, blue sky, cute baby, 8 planets. Okay, now let us come to the actual lesson. Okay, we are working on Shravana Kumar lesson. Now, see, here are the few statements which had come in the lesson. Read the statements and answer the questions that follow. Very nice, children. Shall I read the statement? He took his arrow and aimed in the direction of the sound. This is the statement. And you need to answer the questions. Who took his arrow? What was the sound? What happened when he shot the arrow? Very nice. You are ready with the answers? Okay, let us see the answers one by one. Who took his arrow? Dasharatha took his arrow. What was the sound? The sound was of water filling the pot. What happened when he shot the arrow? The arrow struck to Shravana's chest. Very nice, children. Let us move to the second statement. He rushed to the other side of the river and found the wounded boy crying in pain. Okay, I'll read out the questions. Who rushed to the other side of the river? Why did he rush to the other side? Who was the wounded boy? Very nice. You are ready with your answers? Fine, let us see one by one. Yes, you are right, children. Dasharatha rushed to the other side of the river. Why did he rush? He rushed to other side to find a wounded boy crying. Who was the wounded boy? Shravana Kumara was a wounded boy. Nice, children. Let us move to the next. The third statement. Oh, you are responsible for our sorrow. Oh, you are responsible for our sorrow. Who said this? What was their sorrow? And what was the effect of their sorrow on the king? Okay, you are ready with the answers? Nice, children. Who said this? Shravana's parents said this. What was their sorrow? The pain of separation from their son. Okay, what was the effect, children? Yes, the effect was Sri Rama left his parents in Ayodhya and went to live in the forest. Yes, children, these were the statements and the questions, and you come up with the answers. Good job, children. Now let us move to the next exercise activity. Okay, it is in your textbook. Form new words by adding one letter to the words or changing the letter of the words underlined. Once again, I'll read the statement. Form new words by adding one letter to the words or changing the letter of the words underlined. Okay, underlined words. See, in the first one, L-A-S-S. In the second one, L-A-C-K. In the third one, C-O-L-D. Fourth, R-O-O-M. In the fifth, C-A-L-L. And the sixth, H-E-A-L. Okay, fine, children. You have to add a letter or you can change the first letter. Are you ready? Okay. The first sentence is add a letter to L-A-S-S to make it a thing from which we drink water. Superb. Glass. Very nice, children. Let us move for the second one. And one letter to L-A-C-K to make it a color. Color, name of the color, L-A-C-K. You have to add a letter. Very nice, children. Black. Let us move to the third one. Add one letter to C-O-L-D to blame someone. Kise tabhi galyan dene ka raha to? Aldane ka raha to? Yes. It is scold. Add one letter to R-O-O-M to make a thing used for sweeping. Yes. Broom. Very nice. Change one letter from C-A-L-L to make it ang, one of a cow, that is cough. Change one letter from heel, H-E-A-L. We need to change a letter to mean something we eat in the afternoon. Nice, children. Yes, what do we eat in the afternoon? Meal. Once again, I'll read out the answers. Glass, black, scold, broom, cough, meal. Very nice, children. Now, let us move to the another activity. See, on page number 27, there are the words you can see. Among those words, one word is the correct and rest of them are wrong. Please go through them. I will give you a 1.5 minute for this activity. Yeah, you will get 90 seconds time. Just go through the words. Yeah. One is correct and other. Ek sahi hai. Uldid nala ko tappi de. Okay. Yes, you have to choose the right word that's spelled correctly among the words and underline them. Okay, children. I hope you're ready. Fine. Finished? So early you finished? Okay, fine. Let us see the answers. Okay. For the first one, P-I-L-I-G-R-I-M-A-G-E. That is the correct spelled word. In the second one, F-O-R-G-I-V-E-N-E-S-S. Nice, children. For the third one, F-E-T-C-H. Fetch. Yeah. Fetch means going back and coming back. Nice. For the fourth one, the last word, T-H-I-R-S-T. That is the correctly spelt word. For the fifth one, anxiously. A-N-X-I-O-U-S-L-Y. And for the sixth one, the first word, that is S-U-F-F-E-R-I-N-G. Suffering. Okay. The words on the screen which are in blue color are the correctly spelled word. I hope your words are matching with the words which are in blue color on the screen. Nice children. Let us move for the next exercise. That is on page number 31. Pick out the nouns and verbs from the following sentences and write them in their respective columns. Here few sentences have been given. Okay. You had to pick out the nouns. Nouns means in the earlier classes you have learned. Yeah, in the Guru Nanak classes you have done that gramophone activity regarding naming words and action words. Yes, exactly. Now what you are supposed to do means you are supposed to pick out the nouns and verbs. I will read out the sentences for you. The first sentence, Shravana's parents quenched their thirst. Shravana Kumara was shot by Dasharatha. The customer complained to the manager. Yeah. Children enjoyed watching television. Mother is cooking delicious food for the guests. The sailors landed on the island. You are ready with the answers? So soon you have finished? Okay. Let us check out. Yes, children. In the first sentence, the noun is Shravana. Verb is quench. In the second sentence, noun is Dasharatha. Verb is shot. In the third sentence, the noun is customer. Verb is complaint. In the fourth, the noun is children. Verb is enjoy. In the fifth sentence, yes, noun is mother. Yeah, you can go with food also. Yeah, I have taken only one here. And yes, cook is the verb. In the last sentence, sailor, it is a noun. Landed is the verb. I hope you have finished with that. Okay. Let us move for the next exercise, which is in your textbook. Okay. Children, on page number 31, on page number 31, you have what? Yes, the chunks of words. Yeah. I will read out the headline. So easily you can come up with the answers. As you sow, so shall you reap. What is this? Exactly. This is a proverb. Such proverbs are given below, but they are incomplete. You have to fill other half which is given in the brackets. Here in the bracket it has been given. Yes. Choosing them appropriately. Yes. Yeah. Half of the proverb has been given and half of the part is in the bracket. First I will read what is there in the bracket. Is a friend indeed. Is worth two in the bush. You leap. The best policy is not gold at home. Yeah, these are the half of the parts of the proverbs. Now, I will read the following half Proverbs. All that glitters, dash. A friend in need, dash. Honesty is dash. Dash means blank. Okay. A bird in hand, blank. Look before, charity begins. Okay. You are ready with your answers? Fine, children. All that glitters is not gold. A friend in need is a friend indeed. Honesty is the best policy. A bird in hand is worth two in the bush, isn't it? Look before you leave. Charity begins at home. Very nice, children. Now, on page number 33, yes, few, the letter has been split it up. You have to arrange those splits parts of the letters in an order. Let me see how well you arrange this. Okay, children, see, always in the letter, two address, it should be on the envelope cover. But while you are writing in the examination, you can write it on a left corner of the page. Okay. Now coming to the different parts of the letter. In the beginning, you are supposed to write the address of the sender. If the matter is very less, you can write the address on the left corner of the page, or else you can write it in the right corner of a page. Okay, fine, children. Later, as soon you write the address of the sender, you have to write the date. Next, you can write it that side or you can write it this side. It depends upon the matter, how much you are going to cover. Okay. Next, you have to write dear, because it is informal letter. We have to address it with dear Preetiya. The healthy one, Preetiya uncle, Preetiya auntie, Preetiya geleya, like this. Name of the person. Next, body of the letter. In the body of the letter, we will ask the well-being of a person. And in the second part, in the main part, we will write exactly main reason to write the letter. Then, coming to the last, we will write yours lovingly, name of the sender. If I am writing a letter, yours lovingly, Sahira, like that. Okay, these are the steps we need to follow. Now, as earlier I said you, on page number 33, the letter which has been written by Neela to Raghavendra. Neela's, yes, uncle Raghavendra. Okay, yes, fine. You are ready so early. What you have to do is, you have to arrange the split parts of the letter. If you have given the number, very nice. Later you can write it in a, right format. Okay, fair format, you can write it later. Shall we see the split parts, how you have given the numbers? Very nice, children. Yes, on the envelope cover or on a letter cover, we will write two address. Raghavendra, number 36, Rohini Apartments, Adyar, Chennai, 34. Or also you can write it when you are writing in the examinations, you have to write it on a left corner of you. Okay. Here you are supposed to write is Neela, 94, 4th class, JP Nagar, Bengaluru. Yes, this is the sender. Address of the sender. That is, she's later address of the sender, what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to write the date. 20th May 2020. Fine. Next, I said you. Dear Raghavendra. Yeah, dear Raghavendra. We will address, yes, we will address the person by adding the word dear. Dear Raghavendra. I am extremely happy to know that you are coming to Bengaluru, that you have selected first. Very nice, children. Yeah. Next, main part we are going to write, isn't it? Reason. For what purpose we are writing a letter? The reason. Karana baritivi. Yeah. Enakoskara naavu patravana baritidi ano mukhya karana yenidella madhyadalli baritivi. Luckily, I have holidays during your stay with us. Please bring aunt also with you so that we can go round the city and have fun. By the way, bye. I am happy to say that the weather is fine to move about. Convey my regards to aunt and wishes to Moni. Waiting for your arrival. Later, if you have the place, write it there itself. Yours lovingly. Who is the sender here? Exactly. Neela. Okay. To whom Neela is writing a letter? Raghavendra. Dear Raghavendra. Very nice, children. You all have did the activity very nicely. Fine. Now, it's time for grammar fun. What is this, children? Apple. How do we say it? An apple. A tree. A ball. An egg. A kite. An owl. Now, what we have to do means we have to categorize the pictures and the words based on it. The things starts from consonant sound and vowel sounds. Okay. Well, children, an apple, a tree, a ball, a kite, an owl, an egg. You have done it. Very nice. Yes, a tree, a ball, a kite. These are the words begins from consonant. An apple, an egg, an owl. These are the things begins from vowel sounds. Okay. Children, look here. Already you know that. Let us recall that song. The words a, an, and the are articles. When do we use a? We use a before a word that begins with consonant sound, not a consonant letter, consonant sound. A camel, a doll. When do we use an? We use an before a word that begins with a vowel sound, not a vowel letter, vowel sound. An umbrella, an iron box. The, we use the when we know which noun we are talking about. The bag is blue, the tree is big, the little boy is playing. Yes, along with that, we also use the when we repeat the nouns in the written before. I saw a rat. The rat was black color. This is a book. The book is very interesting. There is a man. The man is waiting for bus. Okay, here is an exercise for you. Yes, you have to fill in the blanks with a, an, or the. The egg is in oval shape. There is dash fountain in the park. The dash children are playing in the field. Dash giraffe has a long neck. Sonal has a puppy. Dash puppy is friendly. Kiran chops wood with dash ask. I hope you are ready with answers. An egg. A fountain. The children. A giraffe. The puppy. An axe. Very nice, children. Now it's a time for assignment. Write a few sentences about the following picture using a, an, and the. One example I have given for at home. Yeah, what you are supposed to do means you have to write some picture. Based on the picture, you have to make a sentences like this. For example, I have taken a picture of boy. This is a boy. The boy is carrying a bag. The bag looks heavy. Well, children, yeah, you have to make as many as sentences with whatever the pictures you can draw, you can collect. Okay, children, I am your teacher, Bibi Sahira, assistant teacher, Government Higher Primary School, Lachankeri, Koppal Taluk and District. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the session. Take care, children. Bye.
ಅನುದಿನ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ